Good afternoon. Welcome to Trinity Church. I'm Earl Tucker, the Director of Trinity Concerts, and we're glad to see you today. Thank you for your contributions. They're greatly appreciated. If you missed our little contribution boxes on the way in, please don't forget us on the way out. Your contributions do help defray the cost of concert promotion both at Trinity Church and St. Paul's Chapel. We ask that you take a moment to turn your iPhones and Blackberries off so that they don't disturb any other members of the audience. And it is my great pleasure to bring you a father, homeowner, and all-round swell guy, Peter Ostrowsko.
Thank you. If you're traveling in the North Country Fair, when the wind gets heavy on the borderline, remember me to the one who lives there. She once was a true love of mine. When the snowflakes snow, when the rivers freeze and summer ends, see for me she has a coat so worn to keep her from the howling wind. Does her hair hang down? Does it roll? Does it flow all down her breast? See for me, does her hair hang down? 'Cause that's the way I remember her best. And I wonder, does she remember me at all? Many nights I have often prayed through the darkness of my nights and through the brightness of my day. Traveling in the North Country Fair, when the wind gets heavy on the borderline, remember me to the one who lives there. She once was thank you.
Hello. After what we went through this morning, this is the reception we get. Hello. We're not in Kansas anymore, Toto. This is Mr. Danny Gotham playing guitar for you. Welcome to Trinity Church, spiritual hotspot in the Wall Street District. We're here for your dining and dancing pleasure, at least until 2 o'clock. Because this is a shortened show from what I usually do, we may have to break down into small discussion groups out in the cemetery, but that's okay. For those of you who like to keep track of these kinds of things, we started out with a medley of mandolin tunes. First one was called La Luna, old Italian piece that I wrote. I wrote it. It sounded Italian to me. And then we did an old Brazilian piece called Quatro Campaneros, and then a French piece, a French musette. Musettes were a popular form of music that developed in and around Paris sometime during the 30s, 40s, 50s, still being played today. The only unfortunate thing about it, other than, I mean, it's beautiful music, but they're all written by accordion players. And so hopefully we saved it from an awful fate. I'm not sure. Let's see, and then we did, I'm from Minnesota, for those of you who don't know. I'm from Minneapolis, Minnesota. And we did a piece by Mr. Bob Dylan, who's a hometown boy there, made his fame here in this very city, but started out his journey in the Iron Range up in Minnesota. A girl from the North Country. And as I've often said, I never really wanted to do any of Bob's material on stage until he started doing some of mine. But I've noticed that neither one of us is getting any younger, so someone had to give. And that's the kind of guy I am. It's not the kind of guy Bob is. Let's see, and then the last two pieces were pieces I learned from the playing of the Renaissance hillbilly himself, Mr. Norman Blake, in Rise and Fall in Georgia. The first piece was a tune that he said he learned from a little book called The Little Book of Missouri Fiddle Tunes. That was a piece called Muddy Creek. And then one of his own, a piece called Jefferson Davis. And that brings us to this very moment in time, and I've said enough. Unless you want to share anything.
We had a great time this morning finding a parking space.
It wasn't even finding a parking space, it was finding this place. There's a lot of one-way streets around here, a lot of dead ends. Danny is originally from the Empire State. He started out his journey in Potsdam, New York, up there on the Canadian border, or,
as we say,
Hotsdam. Hotsdam. But he's a turncoat. Now he lives in the mild climate of Chapel Hill, North Carolina. How did this get in my... I've got a fiddle in my hand, so I'm going to play some fiddle, I guess. Let's see. We're going to do two pieces, originals of mine. One called Medicine Bow, which came to me as I was driving over the Medicine Bow Mountains in Wyoming one time. And then we go into a tune called Christmas Eve Is Coming, Anna, which I wrote for my daughter.
Thank you.
Thank you. I'm going to do a piece now for you called Heart of the Heartland. This is a piece I wrote many years ago for a theatrical production, actually, that was being done in Seattle, Washington. It was a very odd play that died a quick death at the box office. It was called Grey's Anatomy, and it took place in some mythical Midwestern town called Grey. And Wilder, did you say?
Yeah.
I've been getting confused lately. Like Wilder's Our Town. In the beginning of the play, you meet this cast of characters who are the town folk of Grey, and they come out one at a time and tell you a little bit about who they are and what their scam in life is. And one of the characters was a young woman about 16 or 17 years old who lived on a farm. And she came out on stage holding what appeared to be an atlas or a page from a map or something like that. And during her little soliloquy about her life's dreams and ambitions, at some point she pointed to a place on the map and said, "If I told you I lived in the very heart of the heart of the heart of the heart of the heartland, that's where my home is." And as I was reading the script to get some musical ideas, I read that and I stopped and pondered that for a while. And I really loved the way the playwright said that, because the heart of the heartland is not a place you would find on a map. And what she was really saying was that there was a place inside of herself where she could go and chill out when she needed to. And I understood that completely. I think we all have a place like that. Sometimes it's not always the biggest comfort zone, depending on how your spiritual bucks have been in the account. But I used to refer to that place as the land of mashed potatoes and meatloaf. Comfort place. So anyway, as I read that, this music started going through my head, and I decided, originally I was going to call it the land of mashed potatoes and meatloaf, but it didn't quite fit the theme of the tone of the music, so I went with Heart of the Heartland. Thank you. Father, put your arms around me tight, 'cause I'm cold, so cold, dear mother, and I feel so strange tonight. There's a pain, oh dear mother, like some stone upon my breast, and I wish that it would leave me so that I might take my rest. All the day while you were working, as I lay upon my bed, I was trying to be patient and to think of what you said. How there came our precious Jesus for his land to watch and keep, and I wish that he would take me in his arms so I might sleep. So near to death. lying on her mother's bosom. Bessie took her final sleep.
Thank you very much.
Well, that happy number comes to you from the Southern Baptist hymnal. Piece was called Little Bessie. Southern Baptists know how to party. Well, we want to thank you for coming out and listening to music in such a wonderful place, and all the people who are involved in the Trinity Concert Series. So nice to have a place to just go chill out for a little while. This has been Mr. Danny Gotham on guitar. We're going to do one more piece of music, and this is a piece I wrote back in 2002, the fall of 2002. My wife, Marge, is in radio, public radio, and she was producing a radio show out of Minnesota called Speaking of Faith back then. And she came here to New York to cover the last prayer service that was being done down in the pit. And she was befriended by Father Lyndon Harris, who was the priest at St. Paul's Chapel. And he showed her around St. Paul's Chapel and told her about all the work that had gone down and what he perceived as the mission of St. Paul's Church at that time. And she came back a changed person from that experience. And she told me a little story about someone that she had run into at St. Paul's Chapel who explained to her that they thought that St. Paul's Chapel was a thin space. And my wife wasn't sure what that exactly meant when someone said a thin space. And it was explained to her that the ancient Celts believed that the world was enshrouded in a veil. And during momentous times, there would be an unraveling in places in the veil, which were called thin spaces. And in these thin spaces, heavenly things could commingle with earthly things. And so she felt that St. Paul's Chapel, the missionary work that was being done there when the Twin Towers fell, that St. Paul's Chapel was a thin space. And so when she made this radio story, she asked me to write a piece of music for it. And so I wrote this piece entitled Meditation on the Thin Space of St. Paul's Chapel. And as I always do, from the first time I played this tune on the Prairie Home Companion show, probably till my dying day, I will always dedicate it to Father Lyndon Harris.
Thank you.
Do we have time for another one? Play as long as they let me, but okay, we'll do one more. What do you want? Up tempo? Sensitive? Stupid? Red Shoes, my God. That was another lifetime ago. Tecumseh was a shoddy Native American who was rather an infamous fellow in his time. He died in the Battle of the War of 1812, fighting for the wrong side, unfortunately. But if you ever get a chance to read anything about his life, I highly recommend it. Very amazing man. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Mr. Danny Gotham.
Peter Ostruska.
Enjoy the rest of your day.